फ्रेंड्स, दिस लेसन इज गोइंग टू बी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एज वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट अर्थक्वेक, वॉल्केनोस, ब्लॉक माउंटेन्स, पोल माउंटेन्स एंड सो मेनी डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मूवमेंट्स इन द इंटीरियर ऑफ द अर्थ.
News and you have to observe the photographs and you have to answer the questions. So Nepal devastated here, okay? So a powerful earthquake rocks Nepal, nearly 1500 killed. Kathmandu, 25 April, PTI. A powerful earthquake measuring 7.9 on Richter scale struck Nepal today. Nearly 1500 people were killed and over 1,000 people were injured in the disasters. The quake and a series of serious aftershocks delivered a severe blow to Nepal. The tremors were also felt across vast stretches of East and Northeast India. It was also felt in China, Bhutan, and as far as Pakistan and Bangladesh. The earthquake with epicenter at Lumjung, around 80 kilometers northwest of Kathmandu, had an impact in several cities in Bihar, West Bengal and Uttar Pradesh. The initial report said the tremor measured 7.9 magnitude. It said the quake hit at 11:40 a.m. local time at a shallow depth of 11 kilometers. There were 17 major aftershocks measuring over 5 in the next 2.5 hours, said an officer of the National Seismological Center. Another aftershock measuring 6.6 hit within 80 minutes of the quake. This is the largest earthquake in Nepal after 80 years. India has sent rescue team immediately. Okay. Now children, question is what caused the large scale casualties? And the answer is calamities of earthquake led to the large scale casualties. Question number 2, what was the magnitude of the earthquake? So the magnitude of the earthquake was 7.9 Richter scale. Okay. Which country was the most affected because of this earthquake? Nepal was most affected because of this earthquake. Where was the epicenter of the earthquake? Lumjung in Nepal was the epicenter of the earthquake. Which are the other affected areas? So it was the other affected area was Bihar, West Bengal and Uttar Pradesh. You can see here, it is given somewhere here. See here. So that was Bihar, West Bengal, Uttar Pradesh. Okay, Bhutan, Pakistan, Bangladesh were also affected by earthquake. At what depth was the focus located? Focus of the earthquake was located at depth of 11 kilometers. So it is given here at the depth of 11 kilometers. What kind of damage is seen because of the earthquake? So nearly 1500 people were killed and over 1000 people were injured in this disaster. So according to you, can you tell me what could be the reason behind the earthquake? So this answer you will tell, or I should tell you. Okay, I will say. So according to you, what could be the reason behind the earthquake? So sudden release of energy from the interior of the earth leads to earthquake. Okay, so there is a release of energy from the interior of the earth that leads to earthquake. Now we are going to start with the lesson number 2, endogenetic movement. Okay, the endogenic process is a geological process. It occurs under the earth's surface. Many people are not aware of the fact that the earth is always moving because they do not feel it. The movement the earth goes through is caused by the interior of the earth. Now we are going to start with the lesson number 2, endogenetic movement. Okay, the endogenic process is a geological process. It occurs under the earth's surface. Many people are not aware of the fact that the earth is always moving because they do not feel it. The movement the earth goes through is caused by the interior of the earth. Now we are going to start with the lesson number 2, endogenetic movement. Okay, the endogenic process is a geological process. It occurs under the earth's surface. Many people are not aware of the fact that the earth is always moving because they do not feel it. The movement the earth goes through is caused by the interior of the earth. So there are many endogenic processes. They include faulting, folding and volcanism. When this process occurs, it makes way for the different landforms on earth to be created. For instance, when we see volcanoes or mountains, it is an endogenous process that allowed for that to occur. Despite not feeling it, these processes are extremely important to our world. Some people are not too familiar with the endogenic process. There are so many things that can mean. There are a lot of people who have associated endogenic with some of the processes of the earth. Take note that because of endogenic processes, there are so many things that have formed here on the earth. The endogenic process that the earth has gone through have made it possible for different landforms to emerge. Take note that there are so many landscapes that may not have been formed without proper endogenic processes that have occurred in the past. Various natural events occur on the earth from time to time. Example, floods, storms, snowfall, extreme rainfall and etc. Similarly, because of the movements below the earth's surface, natural events like earthquake and volcanic eruptions occur. For the organisms living on earth, these events are disastrous. There is loss of life and property because of natural calamities. So in this lesson, we will get introduced to these endogenetic movement. It means endogenetic movements means it is internal movements of the earth. We are going to study in this chapter. Now see here, as shown in figure 2.2, so arrange your notebooks on each other. Place 3-4 objects like chalk, duster, sharpeners, eraser and etc. on them. It is placed here, you can see. Now quickly take out a notebook without affecting the other. Okay, so we have to take out this notebook without affecting the other, and then we have to observe what happens. Okay, and we can discuss about it. Now see here. Now give a slight push to the structure, observe what happens, then again give a hard push, observe what happens. Carry out a discussion on all these activities. So you can see these books, it is placed on the table, and you have to slightly push to the structure and observe what happens. We have to push like this, and then we have to see that what happens over here. Okay. Third one is, see, arrange the notebooks and keep chalk, duster, sharpener, rubber and etc. on them as in previous steps. So you can see here it is placed. Okay, so now we will see that what will happen if we are pushing this. Okay. Now see a geographical explanation over here. So earthquakes and volcanoes occur because of the instability in the interior of the earth. This instability is created due to the movement occurring in the earth's interior. Okay. Generally, the movements in the earth's interior occur in the upper layer of the mantle. Tremendous energy is released by radioactive material in the mantle. These energy waves travel from one place to another. Due to such a flow of energy, instability is caused in the mantle. The movements are classified on the basis of their velocity, direction, and the landforms they produce. Now see here, the earth's movement is classified, okay, in velocity, direction, landforms. So these are basis of classification. Now we will see movements, velocity and movements. Here slow movements occurring continuously like formation of mountains and continents. Sudden movements like earthquake and volcano will form, you will see here. Okay. So direction, it is in horizontal movement. Here upward, downward movements, landforms. So continent building, it is creating continent, plateau and highlands. Mountain building, folding and faulting. Now see, we will study slow movement. The effect of slow movement can be seen in the form of formation of mountains and continents on the earth's crust. This can be explained as follows. Here we are going to see the effects of slow movement can be seen in the form of formation of mountains and continents on the earth's crust. Okay, so this is of effects pressure, tension. Now we will see the direction of waves movement. When wave moving towards each other, so you will see the pressure, it is here. So when it is moving towards, so that will be pressure. Here tension occurs when waves moving away from each other. Okay. Effects on the hard rock. So what will be the effects on the hard rock? So there will be faulting. And here also see here, it is towards each other and this is away from each other, this side. Okay. Effects on soft earth. So here you will find folding will create, see here, and here fault plane, there will be a distance between them and there will be a fault plane. So we will study about all these things, what is faulting, what is folding, okay, what is tension, what is pressure and all. So we are going to study in this chapter. Now we are going to see a mountain building movements. So that is orogenic activity we are going to do here. So this is activity 1. Take a 30 centimeter long strip. So see here, this is a long strip of 30 centimeter. Place your hands on both the ends of the strip. So it is placed on both the ends of the strip. Move both the hands towards each other, giving pressure on a strip. So this is, you can see here that both the hands are moving towards each other and it is giving pressure here. So that is why you can see this fold over here. So observe what happens on the strip. So you have to see what happens on the strip. Now for this, this is activity 1. So geographical explanation is, the strip was moved by placing hands on both ends. The work performed on the strip at that time is called compression. Pressure was given on the center of the strip from both the ends. As a result, the strip moves and folds are formed. Similarly, due to the pressure on the earth's crust, movements are generated and folds are formed. Okay, so now you know that how folds are formed on the earth. Now see here, this is a fold mountain. Okay, so energy is transferred from the interior of the earth. Because of these energy waves and pressure working towards each other and in horizontal direction, the layers of the soft rocks from folds, if the pressure is very high, large scale folds are formed and their complexity increases. As a result, the surface of the earth gets uplifted and fold mountains are formed. The Himalayas, the Aravallis, the Rockies, the Andes, the Alps are the major fold mountains of the world. So this is figure number 2.6A and here it is 2.6B. Okay, so see here, this is compression, you can find here, and here it is folded part of a mountain. And this is the image of the Himalayas and adjacent areas. This is activity 2. Okay, so you can see here activity 2. Activity 1 I have shown you. So take a long strip of thin paper. Here it is taken long strip of thin paper. Hold one end of the paper in your right hand. Hold the other in your left hand. Now pull both the ends away from each other. And observe what happens to the paper strip. Can you tell me what will happen to the paper strip? Okay, I will give you the geographical explanation in this activity 2. So tension is created when you pull both the ends away from each other. Suppose if I am giving you a piece of paper. Now I will tell you to hold it from both the hands and now you have to pull both the ends from each other. So what will happen? You will see the paper will... You will tear that paper, okay, that time if I am giving you. Because of the tensions and what pressure you are applying in your hand, so because of that. So now in activity 2, tension is created when you pull both the ends away from each other. Similarly, when movements occur in opposite direction to each other, tension is generated and folds are formed in the earth's crust. Okay, then fault will form in the earth's crust. So this is happening in the earth. So that is why you can see folds, fold mountains and all. You will see so many different types of mountains because of this tension which is created in the interior of the earth. Now we'll come to block mountain. Okay. Now see here, this is block mountain, okay, because of internal movement, we are in the interior of the earth. Horizontal waves moving away from each other are formed. This causes tension on the layer of the rocks. This leads to formation of fractures in the rocks. These are known as faults. Similarly, waves coming towards each other in hard rocks also form faults due to compression when a part of the earth's crust in between two parallel faults is lifted. It looks like a block. Now you can see here it is looking like a blocks. Why? Because compression is created over here, and that is why, because of compression, this place has come upward, it has come lifted up. Okay, so that is why you can see here, we can say this is a block mountain. Now Try this, children. This is one activity for you. Take three notebooks of the same size. Hold them on tightly on a table, keeping a distance of 2 to 3 centimeters. Remove the two notebooks on each end away from the central ones. Now observe what happens. Draw the diagram emerging because of the notebooks in your own notebook. Okay, you have to do this. And for this now, geographical explanation is, when horizontal movements on the earth's surface act in opposite direction, when it is acting on opposite direction, it causes tension on the rocks in the earth's crust. When tension increases, fracture develops in the rocks. This leads to formation of faults. Consequently, rocks on both the ends slide and the continuity in the layer of the rock is not fold. Okay? Now see, children, this is Rift Valley and this is totally opposite of the Black Mountains. Okay? So, sometimes two fractures develop side by side. So these are two fractures which has developed side by side in the earth's crust. The land in between the two fracture subsides, this subsided deep part is called Rift Valley. Okay, so you can see here in figure number 2.10 A, and B is also given, I will show you. So both the slopes of a rift valley are steep. Okay. See, this one is the example for 2.10 B. Okay. So this is Rift Valley of Narmada. For example, the Rift Valley of River Narmada in India, the Great Rift Valley of Africa, the Rhine River, Rift Valley of Europe. Okay. Now we will see this continent building. So that is also known as epirogenic movement. Here, slow movements occur towards the center or from the earth's center towards the earth's crust. Because of these movement, a vast part of the earth's crust is uplifted. Uplifted means it comes out like uplifted. Okay. So to get subsided. So when a part of the earth's crust is uplifted above the mean sea level, continents are formed. Okay. So therefore these movements are called continents building movement. Now with the help of this diagram, okay, so I will explain you what is the meaning of uplifted. See, these two parts are uplifted, okay, and one is subsided, it has gone down. Now, extensive plateaus can also be formed because of such movements. If the originally continental portion of the crust subsides below the sea level, it forms a part of the seabed. Now we will see the sudden movements. Okay. In the beginning of the chapter, we have discussed and studied the news items on earthquake. Earth means the ground and the quake means trembling. Earthquake is the movement of the earth's crust. You have been acquainted with the magnitude and effects of the earthquake through the activities at the beginning of the chapter itself. Now we will look at the sudden movements called earthquakes and volcanoes in the earth's interior in details. Do you know? When you stand on a railway platform near the railway track, you experience trembling if a train passes by speedily. Tremors are also felt when a heavy vehicle crosses a bridge in speed. Through these examples, one can estimate the tremors caused during earthquake. Children will study about earthquakes. Because of the movements occurring in the interior of the earth, tremendous tension is created in the earth's crust. When the tension goes beyond limits, the energy is released in the form of waves, and this results in trembling of the earth's surface. So that is earthquake occurs. The magnitude of the earthquake is measured by Richter scale. So how you are going to, how a scientist measures the magnitude of the earth? So they use Richter scale. Okay, causes of earth now. Moving of the plates, colliding of plates. Plates sliding one below the other, forming of fractures in rock layers due to tensions in the interior of the earth, occurring of volcanic eruption. Now children, see all these things. This is the simple seismograph and a graph. Okay, you can see here. See, this is there in your textbook. Children, do you know? Indo-Australia, Africa, Eurasia, North America, South America, Pacific and Antarctica are seven major plates. The Earth's crust is made up of such plates. Oceans and continents are spread over these plates. Depending on the compression and tensions formed in the interior of the Earth, these plates move in various directions. Now children, we will study about focus and epicenter. Because of the movements occurring below the Earth's surface, tension is created and it keeps on accumulating. High energy is released at the place where this tension mounts up. This is the center of the earthquake. It is called the focus or hypocenter. Energy waves scattered in all directions from this center, the place on the earth's surface where these energy waves reach first, is called the epicenter of the earthquake. It is the nearest place on the earth's surface from the focus and it experiences the first tremor. The epicenter is perpendicular to the focus. Okay, and see here figure. This is figure 2.12, types of seismic waves. Children, when the tension is released at the focus, the release energy travels in all directions. This energy comes towards the earth's surface in the form of waves. The seismic waves can be divided into primary, secondary and surface waves. Children, this we are going to continue in our next lecture. Please see this video, okay, and understand. If any problem you will face, you can ask me anytime.